Hello students, here I will talk about one another spot related to immunization, and that is cold chain equipments. But before going to cold chain equipments, let us know what is cold chain. Now you all know that immunization is one of the most effective ways of preventing diseases in a population. Though it seems very simple to give a vaccine to a child, but if we go backwards and explore the actual process of vaccination retrospectively, then we will be able to appreciate the complexity of the whole system by which a child is vaccinated. And this system includes a crucial component known as cold chain. Now, before talking about cold chain, I would like to tell you that a vaccine, it must have two characteristics. One is safety of the vaccine and other is potency of the vaccine. And the cold chain is the one which maintains the potency of the vaccine. So the potency of a vaccine is maintained by cold chain. This is the definition of cold chain. It is a system of storage and transportation of the vaccines at recommended low temperature, usually it is +2 to +8 degrees centigrade, all along from the time and place of the manufacture to the time and place of its use. Now, this temperature maintenance is essential because the vaccines are either heat or freeze sensitive and may lose their potency on exposure to higher or lower temperatures. Now, what are the elements of a cold chain? There are following elements in the cold chain. First is the personnel, that is people involved in managing the vaccine distribution. Second comes the equipment, which is involved in storage and transport of the vaccines. Third comes the transport facilities, that includes the refrigerated vans or vehicles which are required for transporting the vaccines from one place to another place. Fourth comes the maintenance of equipment. And fifth is the monitoring. Monitoring of what? Monitoring the system from time to time. Now this slide is showing the cold chain equipment. Cold chain equipment includes walk-in freezers, walk-in cold rooms, deep freezers, ice-lined refrigerators, vaccine carriers, day carriers, cold boxes, and ice packs. Now this slide is showing the cold chain system. That is how the vaccines are transported from the manufacturing point to the point of use. You can see that throughout the transportation, the temperature is maintained between 2 to 8 degrees centigrade, because this temperature is important for the potency of the vaccine, to maintain the potency of the vaccine. Now you can see that from the manufacturing point, from the manufacturer, the vaccines are transported by air transport in cold boxes to primary store at center or state level, where they are stored in walk-in freezers or walk-in coolers. From the primary store, the vaccine is taken to the state or regional vaccine store in insulated vaccine vans and cold boxes, and at the state or regional vaccine store also, the vaccines are stored in walk-in freezers or walk-in coolers. From the state or regional vaccine store, the vaccine goes to the district vaccine store, where they are stored in the deep freezer or ice-lined refrigerator, and from the district vaccine store, vaccines goes to the primary health center, and there the vaccines are stored in the ice-lined refrigerator. From the primary health center, if you have to carry the vaccines to the sub-center or the vaccination site, that is to the beneficiaries, then you can carry in the vaccine carrier or the cold boxes. You can notice that throughout the transportation, the temperature is maintained between 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. Now taking the cold chain equipment one by one. First, the walk-in freezer or WIF. These are prefabricated modular polyurethane insulated panel rooms where temperature is maintained from 0 degree to -20 degrees centigrade. Now, why these are called WIF? These are called WIF since you can walk inside the room which maintains freezing temperatures. These rooms are installed with refrigeration units and with temperature meter and alarm system for proper maintenance of temperature. These are used for storing OPV and frozen ice packs at state or regional level, and the usual storing capacity is from 15 to 20 lakh doses or more. So these are walk-in cold rooms. These are also prefabricated modular polyurethane insulated panel rooms where temperature is maintained from +2 to +8 degrees centigrade. They are also located at state or regional level and can serve for 4 to 5 districts. And these are used for storing DPT, DT, TT, BCG, measles, hepatitis B, etc. at state or regional level, and the usual storing capacity is from 12 to 15 lakh doses or more. These are cold boxes. They are of different capacities. They may be of 20 liter capacity or 5 liter capacity. Cold boxes are big insulated boxes which are lined with ice packs on the inside walls and floor to maintain a temperature between +2 to +8 degrees centigrade. Now these cold boxes, they are supplied to all peripheral centers. These are used mainly for transportation of the vaccines. But before the vaccines are placed in the cold boxes, fully frozen ice packs are placed at the bottom and sides. The vaccines are first kept in cartons or polythene bags, then they are placed. They should not be placed in direct contact with the ice packs. The vials of DPT, DT, TT vaccines and diluent should never be placed in direct contact with the frozen ice packs. The large box, that is the 20 liter capacity cold box, can store 6000 doses of vaccines with 50 ice packs, whereas the small box, that is a 5 liter capacity, it can store 1500 doses with 24 ice packs. These are deep freezers. These are top opening lid refrigerators and are available at the district levels. Now they come in different capacities like 300 liter capacity, 286 liter capacity, 140 liter capacity, 116 liter capacity. And these are used for making ice packs and to store OPV vaccines. The temperature is maintained from -15 to -25 degrees centigrade. The holdover time for deep freezer is 18 hours and 22 hours at 43 degrees centigrade and 32 degrees centigrade respectively. These are the ice lined refrigerators. These are one of the most important link in the cold chain. The ILRs, they maintain a cabinet temperature between +2 to +8 degrees centigrade and are used to store vaccines at district and sub-district levels. Now these type of refrigerators are top opening because they can hold the cold air inside better than a refrigerator with a front opening. It can keep vaccine safe with minimum 8 hours continuous electricity supply in a 24 hour period. The ILRs are categorized on the basis of vaccine storage capacities. They are of different varying capacity. There may be 300 liter, 286 liter, 140 liter, 116 liter capacity. Usually the larger ILR is supplied to district headquarters and smaller ILR to PHC headquarters based on the size and population. Now based on the temperature zone inside of the ILR, it can be divided into two parts, the upper part and the lower part. In most of the ILR models, the lower part is cooler as compared to the upper part, as the cooler air is heavier and settles down at the bottom of the ILR. Hence, upper part is preferred location for storing the freeze-sensitive vaccines. Now, all the vaccines should be kept in the basket which is provided with the ILR. Vaccines like OPV, BCG, measles, JE, they can be kept at bottom of the basket, while DPT, TT, hepatitis B, IPV and pentavalent vaccines and diluents, they can be kept in the upper part of the basket. Because these vaccines should never be kept directly on the floor of the refrigerator as they can freeze and get damaged. Before taking the rest of the equipments of the cold chain, let me tell you something about holdover time. Now, what is holdover time of the equipment? In the event of power failure, the holdover time is defined as the time taken by the equipment to raise the inside cabinet temperature from its temperature at the time of power cut to maximum temperature limit of its recommended range. For example, in case of ice lined refrigerator, if the cabinet temperature is 4 degrees centigrade at the time of power cut, then the time taken to reach +8 degrees centigrade from +4 degrees centigrade will be the holdover time for that ice lined refrigerator. Now this holdover time depends upon number of factors like ambient temperature. More is the ambient temperature, less will be the holdover time. Second factor is frequency of opening of lid and use of the basket, or the quantity of vaccines kept inside the adequate space between the containers, condition of ice pack lining, etc. This is a vaccine carrier. It is around 1.7 liters in capacity. These are also insulated boxes which are used to carry small quantities of vaccines. That is, it can carry around 16 to 20 vials at a time. These are lined with 4 ice packs on the inside to maintain the temperature between plus 2 to plus 8 degrees centigrade. The holdover time of the vaccine carrier is 34 hours and 51 hours at 43 degrees centigrade and 32 degrees centigrade respectively. Now this slide is showing the day carrier and the ice packs. Now what are day carriers? Day carriers are usually smaller than the vaccine carriers. And they are used to carry small quantities of vaccines, that is 6 to 8 vials to a nearby session. And 2 fully frozen ice packs are used in a day carrier. And it is used only for few hours period. And what about the ice packs? The ice packs are rectangular shaped flat plastic bottles which are filled with water up to the neck. They have definite geometrical shape with 2 depressions in the center for finger grip. When the water is frozen into ice, it is then called ice pack. It is used for lining the walls of cold boxes and vaccine carriers as buffers to maintain cold life inside the equipment. Ice packs maintain cold life for 5 days in cold box and for 1 day in vaccine carrier if it is not opened. This is a dial thermometer which is used for recording the temperature in cold chain equipment. Now, vaccines can also be stored in domestic refrigerators. And these refrigerators, they are front load refrigerators and can be used to store vaccines at private clinics and nursing homes, provided continuous power supply is ensured. Domestic refrigerators, they can also maintain the cabinet temperature between plus 2 to plus 8 degrees centigrade, but the holdover time and capacity to store vaccines or freeze ice packs is limited. Now, how we should store vaccines in the domestic refrigerator? First, the ice packs. The ice packs should be stored in the freezer compartment and they should be kept vertically to avoid leaking with a space of at least 2 mm. Ice packs should be taken out from the left only. All the vaccines and diluents, they should be stored in the refrigerator compartment. We should arrange the boxes of vaccines in stacks so air can pass between them. The placement of vaccines in the refrigerator with freezer on top is as follows. The measles, BCG, rotavirus vaccine and OPV should be kept on the top shelf. DPT, pentavalent vaccine, TT, IPV, hepatitis B and JE vaccine should be kept on the middle shelf, and the diluents should be kept next to the vaccines with which they are supplied. You should keep the ice packs filled with water on the bottom shelf, and you can also keep water bottles in the bottom shelf and in the door of the refrigerator because they help to maintain temperature in case of power cut. And the vaccines which are closer to expiry dates, they should be kept in the front and rest of the vaccine should be kept at the back. At the time of defrosting, the vaccines should be shifted to the cold boxes containing required number of frozen ice packs. And in case of equipment failure or electric supply failure, vaccines should be transferred to ice boxes and then to alternate vaccine storage sites. That is all about the cold chain.